Hey everybody. Today I want to talk about a new product that just got kickstarted earlier this year and so far has already raised $1.5 million. It's the Unistellar eVscope telescope, and it promises to revolutionize astrophotography or astroimaging or observation. I'm not quite sure exactly what it is that they're claiming it can do. According to the spec sheet, it's able to provide up to 100 times more viewing power than looking through a standard telescope all by itself. The Unistellar eVscope has already gained endorsements and a partnership with the SETI Institute, which is pretty impressive. They claim that this telescope should be able to show you faint details of deep sky objects in real time. But is it all hype? That's what we're here to find out. First, let's get a few things about this telescope out of the way. It costs $2,000, and for that price, you get a 114-millimeter Newtonian-style telescope at f4. The telescope is on an altitude azimuth mount, and it has a Sony IMX224 sensor in the optical path. The display through the eyepiece is done through an OLED display screen, and it boasts that it can do a 1,000,000:1 contrast ratio. This would be very helpful in bringing out and teasing the faint details and structures of a deep sky object when looking through this eyepiece. The telescope is battery operated, and the battery is inside the telescope already, so you don't have to carry one with you. The battery supposedly can give you up to 10 hours of operation on a single charge. It has an onboard computer, and that onboard computer handles all of the focusing, the image acquisition, the stacking, and the automatic contrast boosting for the eyepiece. The total weight of this telescope is under 20 pounds, meaning that this is truly a grab-and-go telescope for anybody who just wants to pick it up and take it outside to their driveway, or maybe to a city park, or on a camping trip. Because the battery and the computer are already integrated into the telescope, there's no cabling that you have to mess with, and there's no battery to lug around. So how does this telescope work? Well, without actually having one, and as far as I know, they don't even have a working model out there that we can look at, it seems that the F4 optics bring the object that you want to look at into focus on a Sony imaging sensor. That Sony imaging sensor takes short exposures, and then it stacks those in real time. By stacking those photos in real time, they can boost the contrast and the signal of whatever it is you're looking at, and some very intelligent algorithms built into the computer automatically adjust all of the contrast and the saturation levels for you, and these objects apparently just materialize out of nowhere on the display when you look at it through the eyepiece. This isn't any different than when I or you take pictures with a DSLR camera and stack them on a computer later. The main difference is this does it all automatically and in real time built into the telescope. So what are the limitations of this Unistellar eVscope telescope? For starters, this telescope seems to be a unitasker, meaning it can do one thing and one thing only. Take quick exposures, stack them, and boost the contrast of a deep sky object for visual observation through a digital eyepiece. The exposure length and settings apparently are all determined by the software on the computer, so it doesn't even seem like you would be able to control the deep sky image acquisition yourself. If you wanted to take deeper images of an object, you're not able to do that. You won't be able to take 1 to 2 minute long sub-exposures or 5 to 10 minute long sub-exposures with this. The main reason why you would never be able to do that in the first place is the mount. Being that this is not a German equatorial mount, field rotation is going to be a huge problem. Another limitation that I see with this telescope is that it uses a fast parabolic mirror in the Newtonian telescope design. These fast Newtonian mirrors have a problem with coma out of the outer images of the image. I don't see anywhere in the documentation that this is being addressed, although the Kickstarter campaign and the website go through very few details about the overall design of this telescope. And it's possible that this has already been solved for and there's nothing to worry about. Another limitation that this telescope seems to have is that you can't use any filters with it at all. The IMX224 sensor they're using is a color sensor. Being that it's a color sensor, you should not be able to do any narrowband imaging with it at all. As soon as you put a narrowband filter in front of this sensor, you're effectively killing off most of the pixels on that sensor. Additionally, because the camera is actually in front of the mirror, you can't put a filter wheel in there. It will block all of the light coming into the telescope, totally destroying its light gathering capabilities. So what will this telescope do well? I think that at star parties, a lot of people show up who have never seen a telescope before or even looked through one, have these unrealistic expectations of what they're actually going to be able to see. This telescope promises to be able to give very vivid images like we're used to seeing online and in textbooks. So people who come to a star party and look through this telescope will finally be able to have these unrealistic expectations met in one way or another. As I mentioned before, this telescope weighs less than 20 pounds. So another thing that it will do well is be extremely portable. Being able to just pack it up and leave at a moment's notice would be hugely convenient to a lot of us. One final thing that the makers of this telescope claim it can do is a campaign mode. However, for this to work, the telescope must already be set up outdoors and powered on. If you're away from home, this is very unlikely, unless you've got a remote observatory somewhere either in your backyard, at your club's dark site, or maybe in some property that you own outside of town. But this observatory would have to be fully automated. If you've already got a fully automated observatory with these capabilities to hold this telescope, chances are you've already got comparable or even better equipment than the eVscope is itself, making it a gimmick. It's something that a lot of people probably wouldn't actually have set up for campaign mode. So after going over a few of the features and critiquing them, would I actually buy this telescope? No, I wouldn't. But that's because this telescope does one thing and one thing only, and I don't have a need for that. If you think that taking this telescope out and showing your kids some really cool things in the night sky in real time that they wouldn't be able to see through any other telescope, then buy it. I think that it might actually serve a purpose for you. Another group of people that I think would be suited for purchasing this telescope would be astronomy clubs. I could actually see a few astronomical societies plunking down the $2,000 to pick up one or two of these, loaning them out to event coordinators for outreach, and using them at star parties. I think that it would be a very engaging way to get the public to actually see what they expect to see at a star party instead of a bunch of disappointment at the eyepiece that I've become accustomed to. Beyond those few examples, I just really can't see any reason to justify spending $2,000 on the eVscope when you can spend a little bit less money and actually get a quality optical system on a good tracking mount with a camera that can do the exact same thing the eVscope claims to do. For about the same amount of money, you can purchase a Celestron Advanced VX German Equatorial Mount, which will eliminate the field rotation problem I explained earlier. You can also purchase a StellarView 80mm telescope. Additionally, you can get the Revolution Imager for under $300. The Revolution Imager uses the exact same Sony IMX224 sensor, and it's designed to work like a video camera. The software has already been developed, and it can do the real-time stacking. The main difference is you also have control from your computer to determine how long the exposures are, what the stacking parameters are going to be, and you can also adjust how much the histogram is stretched to give you your contrast. Of course, if you go this route, you lose all the portability benefits that you get with the Unistellar eVscope. It's also going to weigh a lot more than 20 pounds. On the flip side, by losing the portability, you do gain a much more flexible system that you can upgrade later. You can add eyepieces to the StellarView telescope and be able to do visual observation that way. Instead of relying on the Revolution Imager, you can actually later purchase a CMOS or a CCD cooled astrophotography camera with narrowband filters. Or you can throw a DSLR on the back and do color imaging that way. So in the end, I really do believe that the Unistellar eVscope is all hype. It's a unitasker. It does just one thing. It doesn't lend itself to being very flexible. It does not appear that you can actually take the camera out and do a true visual campaign. being that it's a 4.5-inch telescope, or 114 millimeters, at f4 with a digital sensor, you can't even use it for looking at the moon. You can also forget about doing any quality planetary work with it. Jupiter and Saturn are going to look really, really small. And if you were to use a digital zoom on the sensor, which just crops the image down smaller and smaller, it will become pixelated, and it won't be a very good quality image. So if you were thinking about purchasing the Unistellar eVscope at some point in the future, I really hope that you do take the time to think about what it is you're expecting the telescope to be able to do for you, and will it realistically meet your needs? For me, it's not going to meet my needs, and I'm not going to purchase it. You, however, may have totally different expectations, and this is exactly what you need. So thanks for watching, and if you haven't clicked the subscribe button already, go ahead and do so now. It's the easiest way for you to get any updates when I post new videos like this and others. As always, clear skies, and keep looking up.